2018 was a pretty damn good year for games. Looking back at all the games I played and what I mentioned in the last recap, I would say about 80% of the games that came out this year met my expectations. Sony gave us what is probably the greatest superhero game to have come out. Capcom made this new Mega Man game that makes me want to die. Cowboy GTA finally came out and somehow didn't get Game of the Year. Smash Bros. Ultimate is still increasing the roster with this Mario Plant and motherfucking Joker from Persona 5, whose game isn't even on the Switch, this piece of shit of a game. And Resident Evil 2 is coming out with some Uncharted shit. And also Kingdom Hearts 3, so that people can finally shut the fuck up about it. So as the past 6 months finally come to an end, why don't we look forward into 2019 and see what we're getting this year? So as we do, why don't we start out with the games that actually have release dates, which are basically only in February. Jeez, I was starting to forget about this game. So finally, after being revealed back in 2017, Anthem is finally coming out, and it's basically going to be BioWare's take on Destiny. So knowing BioWare and the games that they make, except for that one, maybe this one will be good. Will it be good, EA? Huh? Are we going to have to spend more fucking money just to satisfy your greed and hunger that you want from our fucking wallets, you fucking cocksucking motherfucker? BioWare Destiny comes out February 22nd. Sony's coming in with a new exclusive zombie game called Days Gone, which will hopefully make this game go down the fucking river. One of the most impressive things that people have noticed from Days Gone is the physics and how the bodies can pile up on each other and how you can distract the zombies. It's way more about actually distracting them rather than engaging them, which makes it a little bit more exciting. PS4 players will be able to grab this title on February 22nd. Metro Exodus. 4A Games is proving that there is still a future for single-player shooters that are not only fun, but have such a dark, gritty atmosphere that keeps you on your toes, always ready for the next thing to pop up. It also takes such a great take on the post-nuclear apocalyptic world we're all familiar with, and this game just kills it with the sense of immersion you get. And just, god damn, this game is so fucking brutal! Get prepared February 22nd. Holy shit, it's like that date's a fucking trend or something. Okay, so that's actually all the games that I know release dates for. So I don't know, I think I'm done. Yeah, alright. Well, thank you guys for watching, bye. I'm just kidding. Let's take a look at 2019 and let's see what games we're getting. Devil May Cry. This game is coming out this year and promising the original style of the franchise and not this terrible look for Dante. The next Fire Emblem game is coming out to the Switch, changing the way the battlefield system works, and will probably bring more fucking sword fighters to Smash. Pokemon for the Switch is gonna be a thing, and it won't require you to go outside. Psychonauts 2, this sequel that came out of fucking nowhere at the Game Awards and had no new game for 10 years. Man, sounds like a trend.
What?!
Wasteland 3, reminding us that this franchise exists and created the Fallout genre before Fallout. Cyberpunk 2077, CD Projekt Red busting in here with their newest IP, creating their take on a futuristic RPG, Skull and Bones. Ubisoft finally decides to just make a fucking pirate game without the shitty part known as an Assassin's Creed game. Shenmue 3, after the collection last year, this game finally decided to make a fucking conclusion. Rage 2, looking 100 times better than the first one, making the style look more of a Mad Max world with the colorful creativity of Borderlands. Crackdown 3, remember the last game that had these terrible fucking orbs? That game sucked.
No! Motherfucker! God damn it!
Dead or Alive 6, becoming more fighting and less tits. Star Wars Fallen Order, which is coming out Oh. Gears of War 5 becoming an annual franchise, Sekiro Shadows Die Twice, From Software giving us Ninja Dark Souls that will probably make me want to kill myself, Wolfenstein Young Blood showing that a forgotten series can come back and stay relevant, and this game is adding a co-op campaign, Yoshi's Crafted World, the Yoshi game Nintendo fans gave zero shits about is finally coming out, Bloodstained Ritual of the Night. After the success of the first Bloodstained, this sequel is set to revive what Konami killed that was the Castlevania style games. We'll be able to see Isabelle again without her beating my ass, spawning infinite moons, or these fucking sickos online. Luigi's Mansion 3, finally showing the green younger brother some love. The Outer Worlds, Oblivion Entertainment, who created these games. and teamed up with the creator of these games to make this game, have decided to make this game, and make us forget about the mess that was this game? You want to say something, Todd? Huh? But most importantly, and we'll save the best one for last, Minecraft Dungeons. I'm not kidding. We all know that Minecraft is the best game of all time, so this is just insane. But in all seriousness, there's a lot of games coming out in 2019, and there's no way I was able to get through all of them. But I want to know what you guys are excited for. Be sure to comment below what you're excited for this year, and if you like this video, subscribe for more content like this, and if you haven't already, be sure to follow me on Twitch, catch my live streams, and to all the beautiful people who stayed on till the end, this is Jake, the Mad Italian, and thank you for watching.